Hello, Curious Minds. I'm Miles Maxcer, and this is Black Lighting. Insects use moonlight and starlight to navigate during the night. So our light here, which is an ultraviolet light, brings them in and really kind of confuses them. We use these white sheets because they're the most reflective color. And they bring a lot of insects in from the surrounding forest or desert if we're down in the flats. And we've got quite a showing tonight. This little ant is an alate queen chromatogaster, also known as acrobat ants. So ant alates, another name for winged ants, come into our black light traps. And sometimes that can be a really good way to survey which ant species might be having mating flights that evening. Unfortunately, they're not the best way to get mated queens if you're interested in keeping ants as pets, because only about 40% of winged queens that fly into the traps have actually mated with males and have semen, which is necessary to create fertile eggs. We've got a bit of a treat tonight. This is a female Dobson fly, and they're one of the largest flying insects out here. Now, the males have long, scythe-like mandibles that we believe help them mate with the females, but she has very powerful mandibles, and I've seen them draw blood before. So I don't know if I want to handle her. She's also given me quite a look, but what an awesome animal to find out here. We're being visited by Chrysina gloriosa, which is one of the most amazing beetles that you can find out here. They have this incredible, super shiny green exterior with these golden silverish bands. They're really beautiful and quite large. And they're actually quite painful to get out of your skin because they have these really well-defined hooks. As glorious as this display is, entomologists from around the world have been noting that in recent years there are fewer and fewer insects coming to our black lights and other insect traps. We know that, on the whole, insect abundance is on the decline. And one of the scary things is that we really don't know why. I often think about a quote from Aldo Leopold that said that one of the penalties of an ecological education is that one lives in a world of wounds. And unfortunately, insects don't seem to have been spared by the biodiversity loss that we are seeing all across our planet. Nonetheless, it's absolutely incredible to see all of these insects here tonight, and to know that this diversity exists right here in a forest in Arizona. If you have a black light or even a strong porch light, be sure to send us pictures of the insects that you find. And if you're interested in engaging in citizen science, be sure to use the platform called iNaturalist to post your observations. Scientists can use that information to learn more about the insect diversity of Earth.